Hello. Get ready for some fancy action. This is just a fun bonus video I thought I would record. It's going to be a short one. This will not replace the Doom video for today, which should still be happening as scheduled. For some reason, I thought it would be a good idea to try to finish Contra without continuing, and I thought it might be fun to document some of my attempts to do so. This won't be a regular thing. I'm not going to do this all the time. This is just an apology, you know, video for not doing a full week's worth of videos last week, which I know it doesn't matter. I'm not committed to any schedule, but I feel better about myself if I upload some sort of replacement for the missing videos last week. I don't know how much talking I'll be able to do during this game. Well, during specifically trying to play this game very well, which is what finishing it without continuing will require. I will try to add some insightful commentary, but especially in the later levels, I might have to stop talking so much to focus in on the game. These early levels are no big deal. I've gotten pretty good at the beginning of this game, I say. Since this is the one I'm recording, I'm sure that means I will end up dying and embarrassing myself. But I've gotten to the point where I can pretty much make it to the snow area without dying. Things start to go downhill pretty quickly after that. The energy zone, which is stage 6. I can finish stage 5 without dying. I have before, but not with regularity. But, you know, that's what practice is for, right? And that's all this is practice. I'm not expecting to finish the game on this recording, or even do as well as I usually do. Although so far I'm off to a pretty good start here. I always hated these behind the back levels. I don't mind them so much now that I know how they work. Basically, as long as you're ducking, you're totally impervious to bullets. None of the guns know how to shoot down and at an angle. So as long as you know that, you're pretty safe. The only things that can hurt you are those rollers and the grenades, which the rollers are easy enough to destroy by shooting them. The grenades are easy enough to dodge. This boss can be a little tricky, but since it always starts out the same way with the bullet shooting in the exact same pattern, you can practice it and get it down. Especially if you manage to hold on to the spread gun. Holding on to the spread gun, I feel, is vital to the finishing it without continuing goal. It's not my favorite weapon. I really don't like button mashing. I would prefer to keep the machine gun through the whole game, but I can't give up the tactical advantage of having the spread gun, so hopefully I'll be able to hang on to it for a good long time. It's very important to remember which of these panels are turrets and which ones are power-ups for the purposes of finishing this game. You have a rare moment with no respawning enemies here, so I can stop to take a bit of a breather. So even though, I made a little mnemonic for remembering which is which. If it opens up in 2 sections like that, it's going to be a power-up, and if it opens in 4 sections, it's going to be a turret. I shouldn't call it a turret, I should call it a gun, because the mnemonic uses alliteration. It's 2 is a treat, 4 is a foe, and that's how you remember. But even though 2 is a treat, I actually don't want to shoot this one because it might not be a spread gun. It might be a gun I don't want to use. So I will leave all of these panels alone. Well, I'll shoot the turrets when they appear But I don't want to shoot at any of these, even though it might be, you know, it might theoretically be an invincibility or the R power up, which you would think that would give you like rapid fire or something, but it kind of just makes your bullets move faster. It, like physically, it doesn't actually let you fire faster. I just picked it up here. Like you still shoot the same amount of bullets, and you can't hold it down and shoot, which would be really nice if there was a power up that made any gun behave like the machine gun. But sadly, it is not. So as much as I hate button mashing, oh no, I was still in the hitbox of that explosion. That's a real bummer. And I just let that guy walk on top of me. Well, this is going poorly. Well, I just got an extra life, so that's nice. I'm back to the number of lives that you start the game with, but, you know, for my purposes, that's still not good enough. I need every life I can get for the upcoming levels. Now, this video will probably be even shorter than I thought then. See, I knew. As soon as I started recording and talking, I was going to die early and embarrass myself, but that's okay. It's just a bonus video to reward my loyal fans, my loyal followers. No boss music here, which is weird. This sure looks like a boss. Damn it. Yeah, I'm off my game because I'm recording, but that's okay. For the next one, I will be more used to recording and playing this game, so I will do better. But I've made it to the energy zone without dying, and I've finished the energy zone with about 3 lives left, so that's as far as I've gotten. I haven't made it past whatever the level after the energy zone is called. But, I mean, I'm still doing better than I ever imagined I would do with this game. Like, I never played this game as a kid. I think I had access to it somehow. Like, I was aware of this game. And I think I never played it because... Am I hitting either of those, or am I shooting, like, directly in the middle of those two panels? I think it's directly in the middle. That's kind of funny. I'll have to move over slightly. But yeah, I totally bought into the hype about how hard this game is, because I knew about the Konami code, you know, I knew about the 30 lives thing, and I think even when I did try to play with the Konami code as a kid, I didn't really get invested in it because, you know, I overhyped the difficulty, and I didn't even try, kind of. I think Moore's might have had this game. Because we would trade games and, you know, borrow each other's games all the time. I think that's the only other way I would have known about it. I don't remember. Moores, if you're watching, write in. Did you have, was this one of the games you had? Because I don't know how I would have played it otherwise. Oh well, anyway. However I played it, it did not make that big of an impression on me. But I've come to appreciate it later in life. I think it's a well-designed video game. I don't think it's as hard, you know. It's no cakewalk, you know. Don't, you know, I'm not saying, oh, this game is so easy, lol noobs. I'm just saying that the level of difficulty, which is kind of legendary, this game maybe doesn't deserve quite as much, you know, effusive praise / criticism as it gets. You know, for my money, the first Ninja Gaiden is a million times harder. You know, I would much rather, like, the only reason I'm trying to 1cc this game is because I believe it's doable, you know, with my skills and from watching people play the game. You know, I think it's possible. I could play Ninja Gaiden 1 for the rest of my life and never 1cc that game. Like, that game is brutal. Which is a shame, because I think it plays really well. Like, it's well designed. Alright, this is similar to the boss of the first base, except that you have all these chumps popping up, taking pot shots at you, and eventually these guys turn into Batman, which is a bad time. But basically you want to take out the gun before you take out the red lights, because once the red lights are gone, the actual boss appears. And this is going to be hard with just the pea shooter, but it's not impossible. You just have to make sure you pay attention to all of these bubbles. Shoot them if you can. If you can't, jump over them, because they have some limited ability to heat seek. Oh, I thought that was it. I got another one up at some point. Alright, I gotta at least make it past this level. Come on. After all my bluster, I cannot die at the weird brain in a jar shooting bubbles at me. Gotta at least see the snow area. This does become a much harder game when you play two players, so that might be where some of the justifiable bluster comes from, because this is famously, you know, most people play this game or remember playing it two players. When you play two players, the camera becomes weird. Instead of basically moving when you get to the center of the screen, one of the players has to be like 66% of the way across the screen, or 75% or something like that before the camera moves. And there are a lot of situations where you can get your teammate killed just by moving too fast and causing the camera to... Yeah, see, I'm used to having the spread gun here. Once you lose the spread gun, that's it. It all goes downhill. Okay, well, I gotta do at least one more. That was pathetic. Come on, Duke. You're Lance Trebuchet, famous Contra man. Look at my muscles. Look at my gun muscles. I call them gussles. You don't want to hesitate at that part, because if you hesitate even a little bit, the guy in the bushes will pop out and you're going to have a bad time. A lot of these enemies you could just run past. If you try to kill everything, you're setting yourself up for failure, because this is not that kind of game. So yeah, the effects of the R are not really super noticeable. They're more noticeable in the behind the back segments, I think. I don't know, I guess I'm killing stuff faster, but it doesn't really feel like I am. Another reason I never played this game much as a kid is because I just don't really have that much affinity for the source material that this game is imitating. Like, you know, I never cared about Rambo or Alien or Aliens, which I guess this game came out in 88, so all the H.R. Giger stuff, it's more, you know, I guess Aliens with the S is when that franchise turned into more action movies and less kind of, you know, the second movie, because the first movie was much more of a tense kind of psychological horror thing. I guess the first Rambo movie was the same way, really. Like, First Blood, I haven't watched it, but from what I understand, First Blood is a much more, you know, it's much slower, much moodier kind of movie than the Rambo series. is usually known as. And then the second movie in both series went much more action-heavy. And I haven't seen any of the Rambo movies. I have seen Alien, the first one, and I really enjoyed it. I haven't seen any of the other Alien or Aliens movies because, you know, I do know through osmosis, you know, people talking about them, that they do go in a much more action-heavy direction, which isn't, you know, that's not automatically a bad thing. Like, I do like action movies. I just haven't been compelled to watch them. I would probably watch First Blood just to see what it's like. I'm not as interested in like the, you know, the super kind of shirtless dude bro genre, subgenre of action movies. That's not really my thing. So yeah, another reason I didn't really care that much about this game when I was young. But I mean, it was pretty brilliant for the time, you know. You have these two movies, which are just, you know, total blockbuster hits, and kids can't see them because they're rated R, but they really want to see them. But, you know, they have a lot of FOMO. Unless they had cool parents that took them to R-rated movies. But, you know, kids, they couldn't watch Rambo, they couldn't watch Aliens, but check this out. There's a video game that combines both of them into one thing. Sort of. Not really. But, you know, kids, they want the, you know, anything that's adjacent to the thing that they can't have, they still want that. Even if it's not actually the thing. So, you know, total, you know, brilliant marketing move. This level is especially deadly in two players because if the second player, well, or you know, if one of the players jumps up the screen, you know, faster than the other player is, then they will get pushed off the bottom of the screen and die. And that is very easy. It's very easy for that to happen if you're not paying very close attention, because there's only one jump height in this game. Like, it's not like a Mario game where you can hold the button down a little bit longer to get a higher jump. Like, you press the button, you jump, and that's it. You have a little bit of air control, but not like Mario levels of air control. Kind of plays more like a Castlevania. You know, it's more of a Castlevania jump than a Mario jump. Which I guess makes sense, because it is Konami. Alright, don't do whatever I did to get hit last time. I think I just got greedy. This is a great example of one of those games that punishes you for being greedy. Alright, base 2. There are only two base levels. Which, you know, is a mixed blessing. I don't think they're that fun to play. But they are easy. I tend not to die on them. Well, sometimes I die at the boss of this level, even when I do have the spread gun. It's kind of a lot of stuff to worry about, so it happens. But the level itself, it's just kind of a, you know, it's kind of rote at this point. I mean, conceptually, what you're doing is really cool, you know, working your way through this mysterious alien base, blowing up walls. It's some cool shit. I don't think it plays super well. Yeah, this is much easier when you have the spread gun. I mean, the whole game is. Really, keeping the spread gun is the key to finishing this game. You know, legit. Sweet, another extra life. I have more than fit on the screen. It's a powerful feeling. if you press up here, you walk into this electric force field, but it doesn't kill you. It just stuns you for a sec. This thing looks like a big old poker chip. It's Contra, Aliens, and Batman. It has everything. And I've heard some people say that this boss, the brain in the jar thing, looks a little bit like Optimus Prime. So you have Transformers in there as well. Just everything about the 80s is present in this game in some form. I don't really know what Optimus Prime looks like, so I can't say how accurate the comparison is. All the Transformers kind of look the same to me from the cartoon. I've never seen any of the live-action ones, quote-unquote live-action. 6 extra lives. I shouldn't talk about how well I'm doing. Nothing good ever comes of it in any game. Alright, don't want that because I already have the spread gun, whatever it is, machine gun. I mean, I'd like to use the machine gun, but I just can't afford it. I forget what that is. R? Sure, I'll take an R. I always hesitate too much with these grenades, and it always costs me. You can't get greedy, but also you can't dawdle, because dawdling means there's just more shit on the screen you have to deal with. You have to find the right balance. It's kind of like Doom in that way. You know, Doom is a game that rewards you for continuing to move, but also you don't want to get greedy in Doom either. You know, if you go for that power-up before you know it's safe. The game will punish you. Usually with monster closets. Or in the later games, monsters that teleport in. Oh, I'm glad Doom 1 doesn't have a whole lot of teleporting monster traps. That really becomes more of a thing in the later games, and I'm not a fan of it. At least with monster closets, you can kind of anticipate it, because you have this big space where there doesn't seem to be anything. So you can sort of guess that there's going to be something there at some point. If you remember it, of course. Don't really care what that is. Finding the right place to stop between the grenades, explosion, hitbox. It can be tricky. Alright, this boss is a total joke if you have the spread gun. Yeah. If you get here with the pea shooter, still doable. I'm almost guaranteed to die, though. 7. Rest 7. Look at that. I'm kicking ass and murdering hundreds of humans. But I mean, it's okay. They're in league with the aliens, so it's fine. There's going to be a lot of stuff at the bottom of the screen during this section, and it's going to freak me out a little bit. I just need to remember none of it is a threat to me. This is a threat to me, though. Fire is very much a threat to me. I'm allergic to fire. It makes me break out in burns. I'm also allergic to bullets. But luckily I have an antidote for bullets. It's more bullets. I don't have an antidote for fire, though. I think I gotta just go for it here. This jump sucks. Oh, good. Ah, damn it! Hesitated just a little bit too much. You gotta be careful when you drop down here, because you stand up briefly before you drop through the platform. It's very easy to ruin your day that way. Alright, high road is definitely safer here. I should not have survived that. Oh boy, I am on borrowed time right now, let me tell you. Alright, and I can just drop down here. Alright, this boss sucks, but it's doable with the pea shooter, unlike some of the other bosses. Boss has a pretty predictable pattern. Once it starts walking forward, it's going to continue walking forward. So you don't have to worry about it, about getting juked or anything. But with the pea shooter, it takes a million hits to die, so easy to psych yourself out here. Just because of how long it takes. Ah, damn it. You know, I would argue that your lives in this game are actually a life bar. You know, they're actually hit points. And your continues are your actual lives. Because, I mean, typically when you lose a life, that's, you know, that's a setback. Like, it'll take you back to the last checkpoint, or, you know, if it's, damn it. If it's a really punishing game, take you back to the beginning of the level, or kick you out of the level, or something. But in Contra, I mean, you just spawn right back in. So, it's really more of a health bar hanger. Alright, this level's a jerk. So, those red tracks down there, totally looks like something that'll kill you. It's not. You can just walk right on it. Like, they look like some sort of electrified track, right? Funky gun. I call F the funky gun, because it reminds me of the funky bombs from Scorched Earth. But I think it's supposed to be the flamethrower, or the fireball. But, I mean, you have to admit, the projectile does move in a very funky fashion. Can I get back up there? No. I usually don't take the low road here, so I'm a little spooked. Okay. Oh, right. Spike wall's out of nowhere. I didn't think these would be until later. The thing about doing a 1cc run of Contra is that I don't see these later levels all that often. So I'm not as familiar with them, and it's going to take more practice, but, you know, that's part of the challenge. Alright, I think I want to take the high road. Nope. I mean, it'll be fine. It'll work out, but... Alright, that's a treat. Alright, so if I ride this minecart up here... Actually, I think this is... Yeah, it's just an invincibility. Screw that. I don't want to be invincible. You want to live forever, asshole? I mean, yeah, if possible. Alright, this is another jump that sucks. I want that S. Why isn't stuff moving? There it goes. Hmm. Interesting. I had forgotten about that aspect of the claw. I wish you could just hold the button down. Mashing never adds anything to a game, except thumb pain. I have no desire to prove how good I am at pressing a button very quickly. But if I'm going to 1cc the game, it has to be legit. I thought about just figuring out how to do it, keeping the machine gun through the whole game. But with the bosses particularly, I don't think that's very possible. Alright, I have yet to defeat this boss, so we'll see how this goes. As it's not really even a boss. It's just a place that sucks. My gut tells me don't worry about killing the guns. Just focus on the D-pad. Okay. That worked out. Shooting down isn't the easiest thing in this game. Ooh, here we go. Alien apostrophe S. That wasn't even a movie. Oh, that is just a xenomorph. Like, it's not even derivative. It is just the thing. I guess in the movie, the xenomorph didn't burp shrimp at you. That's an innovation. Like, even if I had tried to aim diagonally at that thing, you cannot aim diagonally and move at the same time. The thing about the NES controller, alright, is that it only had two buttons. So, there were only a limited number of actions you could do at the same time. You couldn't press a button to aim diagonally because, you know, that would be all of your buttons. I mean, if you also want to be able to jump, which is kind of important. Oh, touching fuzzy doesn't make you dizzy in this game. It's touch fuzzy, get dead. I mean, at least you did have two buttons, unlike some of the computer games of the time. Like, God, imagine playing Contra. Like, imagine playing the ZX Spectrum version of Contra with its one-button joystick. Imagine having to press up to jump. That's not something anyone wants to do. Metroid has its mother brain. What are some other organs we can have instead of a brain? Some other, you know, what's another scary organ? Ah, I know, the heart. Well, that was the final boss, which is a lot better than I was planning to do on this run. 231,000 points, that's the best number I've seen so far. Shit, my next best score is like 160K or something. So yeah, this is definitely doable. I might actually do another one of these videos this week. This was just going to be a one-off, but I was honestly not planning on doing so well. So this has been Duke Arcade, one credit Contra, or whatever the hell I'm going to call this. Thanks for watching, and tune in for your regularly scheduled Doom video tonight. Goodbye.